Imagine an immense cosmic butterfly floating in space with wings that seem woven from light and shadow next to a giant brain pulsating with stars and nebulae. These awe-inspiring shapes in the universe, although they may seem like something out of a fairy tale, are real. They are nebulae formed by the death of stars, creating a spectacle of beauty and mystery. However, if we look at it another way, we might ask, could the universe, with all its wonders, be something more than just celestial bodies? Could it somehow be considered alive or even conscious? This idea may sound like science fiction, but when we examine cosmic structures more closely, we find something astonishing. The networks of galaxies in the universe bear a striking resemblance to the neural networks in the human brain. This similarity goes beyond mere visual coincidence. It leads us to question the boundaries between the living and the inanimate. Could the universe, with its countless stars and planets, somehow resemble a gigantic living organism? And if so, what would that mean for our understanding of the cosmos? To explore this question, scientists have compared neural networks in the human brain to cosmic networks of galaxies. They have found many similarities that go beyond mere visual coincidence. These findings raise a fascinating hypothesis. Are we living within an immense cosmic brain? Some theorists, considering this evidence, suggest that the universe may be conscious, operating on a scale and in a way that we can barely begin to comprehend. However, there are significant challenges to this theory. In our brain, signals move quickly, allowing for nearly instantaneous communication and processing. In the universe, though, the speed of light imposes a significant limit on how fast information can travel. This limitation makes it difficult for the universe to think and react like a human brain. But let's consider this idea further. Think of small brains spontaneously forming in space. The laws of physics, in theory, do not exclude this possibility. For example, the air in your room is composed of billions of gas molecules. What if, by some extraordinary coincidence, these molecules came together in a way that resulted in a form of life? This possibility, though extremely unlikely, opens up a world of speculation about the nature of the universe and life. Ludwig Boltzmann, a pioneering physicist, proposed that in an infinite universe, anything that can happen will eventually happen. This would include the spontaneous formation of complex structures, such as brains, from chaos. However, the discovery that the universe is constantly expanding brings a new perspective to this idea. The universe's expansion makes the occurrence of such spontaneous events less likely, as space is becoming increasingly diluted. The theory of the Big Bang as a quantum fluctuation offers another intriguing perspective. It suggests that the universe may have originated from a spontaneous burst of energy in empty space. If this theory is true, then concepts like spontaneously formed brains in the universe would be possible. This leads us to a deep philosophical question. How can we study a universe that may, in its essence, be a collection of random events? Some scientists worry that the universe may self-destruct before these spontaneous brains can manifest. On the other hand, we are living in the era of artificial intelligence, AI, and nanotechnology. These emerging technologies have the potential to radically transform our world and perhaps even create new forms of life in space. However, we also face the risk of losing control over these powerful innovations. One of the most concerning theories is that nanorobots could transform all matter into a self-replicating substance called gray goo. This would turn the entire universe into something alive, but in an entirely unexpected and potentially catastrophic way. However, some theorists propose that the existence of intelligent life, like us, is already an indicator of a living and conscious universe. They argue that if the fundamental laws of the universe were slightly different, life as we know it would not exist. This fine-tuning of universal constants has led to the development of the anthropic principle. This principle suggests that the universe is as it is because we are here to observe it. Furthermore, some go even further and discuss the fundamental consciousness of the universe. This theory proposes that everything around us, even inanimate objects like stones may have some level of consciousness. In this model, the entire universe would be a vast collective experience of conscious beings, ranging from humans to bacteria. One of the most surprising ideas is that each black hole could be the beginning of a new universe. According to this theory, the universe reproduces itself through black holes, which act as seeds for new cosmos. This would imply that we are living within a mother universe, part of an infinite chain of universes generating new universes. These theories lead us to reconsider what we know about the cosmos. They suggest that the universe is much more than a vast expanse of space and time filled with celestial bodies. It may be that we are immersed in a complex and astonishing cosmic organism, alive and conscious in ways that we are only beginning to understand. So, which of these hypotheses do you find more plausible? Each new discovery in the fields of astronomy, quantum physics, and neuroscience brings us closer to understanding whether the universe is merely a collection of matter and energy, or something much more mysterious and wonderful. The universe remains a fascinating mystery, and exploring its depths is one of humanity's greatest adventures. We are only at the beginning of our journey to understand the true nature of the cosmos. Perhaps one day, we will discover that the universe is indeed a living and conscious entity, challenging everything we think we know about life, consciousness, and our own existence.